If someone texts jump drive, I'm from that point on trying to not let them win anymore. Hey, TechNova, thanks for the prime. Welcome, welcome, welcome. It's the same thing with boats. Like, I would sooner prop someone else up than just let the voter win. The wasps are cross again. Have a good start this time. Is there a quick supply? There. Oh, wait, that's me. There is another quick supply. We'll just bank it and rhino drop next turn. Points for me. Hackers, still no air. Let's take a cheap rhino. Is there any reason to beacon? Gonna chill. That is fine. Money. I mean, the hackers are gonna go down anyway. Like, I've got crawler rhino. I feel like their natural aggro just is more foolproof. Like, the annoying thing with beaconing melee units is if the thing that they're trying to shoot isn't in the beacon, they just walk right past it and get shot at. Yeah, but like beaconing isn't, like beaconing is just as likely to make a mistake. Like I've had enough bad beacons to just not want to beacon in these spots. What are we adding here? So you're on arcs. You've got stangs. I can range these. That's fine. Yeah, I mean, stangs are okay into everything. They're not good into the arcs, but do I need to be good into the arcs? You think he'd beacon into my tower? That'd be so annoying. Whatever. Okay. Got sold, I think? Got relocated. Interesting. So what, Stormcallers look okay here? Steel balls into these. Snipers? Nah, they're too slow. The problem with marksmen in this army is you'll clear your wave and then your marksmen get left behind and you've got two armies. Someone goes around, your marksmen just die for free because they have nothing protecting them anymore. It's really important in this mode for your army to be the same speed. Stormcallers have the same problem, but at least they've got the range to make up for it. A splash to make up for it. Still not really what I want to be doing, though. Steel walls are maybe okay. Ugh. super rich. Well, find a clear here. In my flank. I think the last two turns, yeah, as well. Doesn't really do much. I still got all the points on the map. I don't think it stopped me from winning. Maybe it did. Just chill. Yeah, I don't mind having these here. I'd probably prefer to be them across, but... they are nice and tanky. Who's sort of the right speed? Time to get run over by the boss. Somewhat likely. I don't know if crawler levels even matter here. Stangs are just a lot better at clearing bosses than I thought. A big problem with the bosses this patch is that the chaff is a nightmare. Stangs do deal with the chaff. Well, that's four, five, six, sure. Yeah, this boss is just busted. Okay. That's... yeah, fair enough. Fair enough. Fucking death knell. answer is tricky beacons, generally. The callers for the arc lights. Yeah, I mean, just everything be a ball. I should have saw this coming. Big win for yellow. Heavy armor is what this is about. The callers. Oh, I missed. I didn't realize there were stangs here. Well. Like we win. Don't think there are any longer enough points on the map. going on over here? They did it. Good game. Angered some people in the past. Yeah, that's kind of what happens, though. I don't know. It's a big part of why I stopped playing the, like, heavy flank comps, is when you fight the same people over and over again, they will be determined to not lose to you. Like, it even happens in the same game sometimes. Like, I had a game where I had a pack of crawlers over here that I beaconed into the tower on round 4, and then for the rest of the game, that player was all about me no longer winning the game. They, like, threw Vulcans on my flank, beaconed all sorts of nonsense into my base. There's a lot of benefit to just not tilting the lobby. Anyway, I'm gonna take a quick break. Be back in, like, 2 minutes. Hope you guys stick around.